been a life-changing experience, and it kind of trains me for any kind of situations in my life. So yeah, and also I wanted to understand about the target audience. Like, why is it mainly the corporates? And
so for me, any civilian is a target. So the TG is any civilian who can afford training, and is looking for an experience and a lifestyle change. So you kind of get a wake-up call across by doing any of these around. The TG is corporates because that's the business that I understand. I understand the mindset and the psyche of a corporate. I've been designing for corporate India almost all my life in 2 decades. So I understand the language they understand. And successfully satisfying their requirements gives me constant flow of business and backup. So they are the ones who are my clientele at Della Adventure. They are the ones who are my clientele at D.A.T.A. That's the language I understand. Even in my design world, I understand that language and have designed hundreds of corporate headquarters, hundreds of corporate offices. It works very well. Also, there is it's a twin-sided win-win situation, because every time a corporate comes to you for learning at D.A.T.A. or Della Adventure or Della Resorts, the individuals of the corporates come back with their families, because they're just waiting to go back home and get their kids, get their friends, get their families, do their anniversary, do their birthday, make it a special celebration across. And it remains, D.A.T.A. remains as a life-changing experience for each and every one of them.
That's absolutely true. In fact, when I was going for training, I had seen youngsters as well as older people as well being trained.
Right.
So I think that's been amazing, that you know how it caters to all the target audience. And could you tell me that how does Della D.A.T.A. ignite the passion for the country?
So for us, it all begins and ends with, are we able to achieve what we've set forth our vision to achieve? So when you come in, you listen to the first Jai Hind, the way the formal welcome is given to you as a civilian. You're not used to getting a formal ceremonial welcome ever in your life as a civilian.
Right.
The horses, the dogs, the guards, the ceremonial uniforms, and the Jai Hind, the salutations. You walk through the whole thing, a patriotic music playing in the background, lighting, igniting lamp at Sarvadharam Sthal. So a civilian is getting a wake-up call when a civilian enters inside. Then you're given uniforms and you're asked to change. You're looking at the obstacle course at the epicenter of our entire training facility. You kind of, you're just soaking it in. It's all working on you.
Mm-hmm.
Then you listen and get introduced to the kind of trainers who are going to train you. Starting at the highest level with Lieutenant General Rivendarana as the director of the training operations, and the general, the colonel, the zubedars, the captains, the Marcos commandos, the NSG commandos, the paratroopers. Listen, these are really, really specialists.
Right.
And it's awe-inspiring to just listen to their stories and listen to them and meet them in person and understand the kind of achievements they've done for the country and the sacrifices. So you listen to each one of their backgrounds and you kind of soak it in and say, dude, this is serious.
Definitely.
Then you realize this is not light-hearted training. This is not some Lallu Panju Jawans training you.
Yes.
These are serious people who've been there, done that, and each one has really achieved a great deal for the country and sacrificed a great deal for the country.
Yeah.
So Raymond Boy had set up the first core mountain task force against China. Now he can talk about China in a very different way to corporate leaders.
Yeah.
There's a program of boardroom to boardroom that really fascinates people, and a lot of learning from a man who's led a million soldiers. So that's how you kind of start igniting passion for the country and say, dude, I have done nothing for my country so far.
Mm-hmm.
Least I do is respect the armed forces. That's the basics of patriotism, is to respect the people who protect you.
Right.
So that's one. And then you listen to the next level. And then in case of a aggression from a terrorist, how do you protect yourself and how do you make others survive?
Right.
So you have to don the sense of responsibility of kind of surviving yourself and making others survive. All of this, all in all, by the time you leave this facility, you have patriotism ignited in your belly for sure.
That's amazing. In fact, yeah, I had heard that you know one of the commandos had taken the bullets in his heart, and he had survived it and flaunted so proudly. I mean, it just makes me realize that there's so much more for us to do for other people. You know,
serving in the valley, he has 3 bullets in his body, and he's working and he's training. So when you're learning from a man like that, and he's proud in training. So kind of, he's he deserves the respect that you give him, because he's taken 3 bullets in his body for the country, and he's standing there, and he's yet training people
right.
more and more on how to survive.
Mm-hmm.
Who better to learn how to survive from somebody who's been through that? The 2 of our commandos are the first ones, respondents, as the 8 Marcos commandos
right.
when Taj was attacked. So they evacuated 250 people from the ground floor to the 4th floor. Now, who better to learn survival from people like that?
So, yeah, everything has been so thoughtfully created. The rooms, the private jacuzzi, the luxury boot camping. So, I just wanted to understand that what exactly is the USP for people who are coming first time to Della? Like,
anybody who's a civilian
yeah.
and wants to explore experiential hospitality,
yeah.
this is welcome here. And believe you me, they're going to have an experience of a lifetime that they're not going to forget. Because there is, they imagine a boot camp and come here. They imagine some shoddy kind of tents and in the jungle accommodations and kind of sleeping in sleeping bags. They're in for a rude shock because the level of luxury that they experience over here, they haven't imagined it in their lifetime. And that's what we've tried to do by marrying the best of design, the best of hospitality, the best of luxury, the best of training together, all put together is an experience to carry for a lifetime and memories for a lifetime. So you have your followers who want to celebrate their birthdays, their anniversaries, friends need to come together, building people want to come together, youngsters need to come together, college kids need to come together. This is for all ages, and especially for people who want to travel abroad. And go through the chances of being exposed to a knife attack or a terrorist attack or an attack of a active shooter. For them, this is fantastic because the training that they get here, it'll really, really serve them in good stead.
Yeah. Thank you so much. That was really insightful and it was lovely having an interview with you. Thank you so much for having
My
me.
Pleasure. Love you. Jai Hind.
Thank you.